Hi everyone, today we are going to learn about networks. So let's see what is a network first. Now there are some contents you should cover, so let's see what are those. First of all, we have to know what is a network, so we'll learn it later. And then what is a node? The node, the word is new but it's familiar, right? And the network technologies, and then network topologies. So those are two different things. And network devices and medium. So what are the devices we need to connect a create a network? And then we have advantages and disadvantages of the computer networks. So these are the topics we are going to cover. So first of all, we are going to learn what is a network. Actually, it is a computing device connected together. That means you can connect one computer or more. One or more computers connected together with any other several devices that performs a network. So that computing devices, it can be a mobile phone, a printer or server or any other thing. So internet is the largest network we have. And then I told you we are going to learn what is a node. So node is nothing but it is the computer. It is a computer or any other device connected to the network. So here you have seen three computers connected to the network. That means you have three nodes. So that is just a change, just changing the name. So computer is a node. So this can be a simple personal computer or smartphone even. And then, now you know what is a node. It is basically the computer. And then the network technologies. So when it's come to network technologies, we have PAN, LAN, WAN, and WLAN and MAN. So PAN stands for personal area network, LAN stands for local area network, WLAN stands for wireless local area network, MAN stands for metropolitan area network, and WAN stands for wide area network. So we are going to learn one by one. Okay, now we are going to learn the first technology, PAN, personal area network. This is a very small network where you connect only 2-3 nodes, devices at the time. And a single person can access this network. So once you connect your laptop, computer and a mobile phone via Bluetooth technology, you can call it PAN, personal area network. PAN, you know that it stands for personal area network, and very small network as I told. So this is a personal area network. And the second one is LAN. LAN stands for local area network. Normally these type of networks is restricted to a small geographical area. That means the best example is an office network. Also your computer lab setup, it is also following the LAN technology. And then WLAN. That stands for wireless local area network, as I told. So once you go through this picture, you can see that no cables are connected from one device to another or one node to another. That means that is wireless, and this is in a limited geographical area. So that is a local area network. So we call these all together wireless local area network. Only the difference is WLAN and the LAN will differ. Only WLAN uses Bluetooth signals, Wi-Fi signals, and the LAN uses all the cables. And the next one is MAN, Metropolitan Area Network. These networks connected nodes across cities. Now I told you LAN is a small geographical area. So MAN is not a small geographical area. It will now let's say you have a you, if you take a bank, so a bank can have more branches. So those branches should be connected over cities. This kind of a situation we use MAN, metropolitan area network. That is obviously the larger than local area network. So you can say that's a collection of local area network also. So example, as I told, branch network of a bank, even your school can take. You have several branches. So our school also connected through a MAN technology. And then WAN, wide area network. In the beginning, I told you the internet is the largest network we have. So wide area means that is not a limited geographical area. We can't measure the area when it comes to WAN. So the internet is the best example for WAN, wide area network. That is even larger than MAN. So it can spread across the cities, countries. So obviously the internet is the best example for this WAN. And the network, now we have learnt about network technologies. Now next we are going to learn network topologies. Network technologies and network topologies, two different things. So network technologies are how we set up the nodes and everything according to the technology, not the setup, not the physical setup of the physical type. So when it comes to topology, how we arrange these nodes in a physical area, what is the setup? One computer next to that or behind that, so that is the topology. So when it comes to topology, you can have bus topology, ring topology and star topology. So we are going to learn one by one. The first topology we are going to learn, that is bus topology. So it's set up like a bus from one end to another end, and the main advantage is it is easy to set up. So the cost is very low and there are so many advantages. No server computer here, so all the nodes are same, no centralized computer, and it is very difficult to find the errors in here. And if the main cable breakdowns, damage, then all the nodes are fail to communicate with other nodes. So those are the disadvantages. And the next topology is ring topology. It is set up like a ring. This will create a ring like pathway. Data and information will go through each node when one node wants to communicate with other node. So there is an advantage, and the setup cost is low. Main disadvantage is very slow in operation. If one computer wants to communicate with the other computer, it takes too much time to travel from one to another and then that to another computer, like that. So single node is connected with another two nodes, as you can see, and data will go through each node. So that's why this setup is very slow. And the last topology type is star topology. There is a centralized node. When it comes to this topology, star topology, there is a centralized node normally set up with this, and all the nodes, other nodes are connected to that centralized node. So the advantages is very easy to find errors because one computer directly connected to the central computer. If one computer is not working, that will not affect to the other computers. So that is also an advantage, and very fast in operations because it directly communicate with the nodes, what are the nodes that should be communicate with. Then there is one disadvantage, that is the setup cost is very high because we need lot of cables for this. And now next we are going to learn about network devices and what are the mediums we used in set up a network. So the first one is coaxial cable. So these cables are used to send data to one node to another. They are similar to the type of cables you see in your television antenna. So this is the coaxial tape cable. And the next cable is the Ethernet cable. These cables are mainly used for computer networks. That means most of you all have seen your telephone line will connected using this this cable to the modem or the router. So this is we call Ethernet cable. This is used to set up the network, and most LANs use Ethernet cables to connect nodes. To connect nodes also we use this from switch to the node. And this is a hub. That is a network device we usually need with setup. It is a device which can work as the central node for ring networks. So it can work as the central node. So it has some ports to connect the cables, and hub will release the data or the information to all the computers, and the relevant computer will catch up the data. So it will freely travel within the network. It release the data, and the particular computer have to come and catch the data. So that is the hub. That means hub is not a smart device. That is not smart enough to send one data to the particular computer only. It's release the data to the network. So the computer will catch the data, right? And then, so this is a hub, as you see. Next device is switch. It is very similar to the hub, but the work is different. Actually, the switch is smarter than hub. How? Hub will release the data, and the computer should be smart enough to catch the data. But switch, it's not like the hub. It will send the data to the particular computer only. Therefore, the switch is very smarter than the hub. So that is the main difference also. So this is the hub. Now if the hub wants to send data to the computer C, it sends only to the computer C. It won't send the computer D and then to the C. So it will not release the data to the network. It sends only the particular computer. And now let's see what are the advantages of a network. That you know we can share the files. If the network is set up, we can store the files in a centralized place, and then we can share. And then nodes communicate is faster via email or chats. So when it is a network setup, so we are sharing everything. That means the data sending rate is very fast. So some softwares can be shared across the nodes. That means let's say you want to install Microsoft Word, then you have to put the setup within the one computer, then you can install to the every computer if the computers are in a network. And data backup is very easy. If you want to backup data of another computer from a very different computer, you can do that. You don't have to go to that computer and access. And their devices, especially the printers, can be shared. Now let's say if you are having five computers in the network, so you will have only one printer. You can share the printer. If the computers are not networked, then you have to have one printer for one computer. So the sharing of devices is the main advantage of a computer network. There are disadvantages also. So high initial cost to set up when it's come to specially to start topology. The setup cost is very high, and we need a trained staff to handle the network. So we have to pay them a salary. So that is again cost is very high, and we need a special technical skills to handle the network. And computer viruses can be spread very quickly. Once it comes to one computer, it will quickly spread to the others. And the hackers may attack to your computer. So once the hacker gets into one computer, it can easily pass through the other computer. Okay, now you have learnt a lot. So this is the summary you learned. So you know what is a network. So it's a collection of one or more computing devices. And you know what is a node. Actually, the node is a computer. And you know what are the technologies. Mainly there are 5 technologies: LAN, WAN, PAN, MAN and WLAN. And the network topologies. We have learned 3 topologies: star, bus and ring. And the network devices and mediums. When it's come to devices, we have learned about hub and the switch, and you know the main difference. And when it's come to mediums, you have learned about. So let's discuss some questions. Okay, first question, mention the suitable devices for the following. First one, the device sends the information coming from one node to all the nodes. So that should be the hub. And then the second question, the device that will send data only to a specific node instead of sending to all the nodes. That means that is the switch. Actually, this is the main difference between switch and the hub. And the next question, choose the correct answer. Which of the following is not a network topology? Bus is a network topology. Star is also a network topology. Ring is also a network topology. LAN is a network technology, that is a local area network. So the answer is LAN. And here, which one is the type of cable used in networks? Switch is not a cable, it's a device. PAN is a network technology. Ring is a network topology. Ethernet is the network cable. So that is the cable we used in network. So now let's see this question. What are the advantages of a network? First one is we can share the files with save in the one location with each and every nodes. And the second one, the nodes communication is faster via emails or chats when it comes to the network. And we can share the softwares across all the nodes within the network. And the data backup is very high and very easy. And then the last one is we can share printers, scanners or projectors if it comes to the network. So I hope you all learned a lot and you all enjoyed a lot. So thank you for joining with me. Have a nice day, children. Thank you very much again.